In design, there is an idea, an intention, a desire to transform, to alter space in such a way as to inspire the mind and uplift the soul. In nature, sometimes things just come to be. At times, design and nature are inseparable. These rare moments begin when an idea or intention takes on a life of its own. Starting small, these rare moments grow and become whatever they are meant to be. In the spring of 2010, one of these rare moments came to life. Friesian horse breeders, Bryce and Kim Holmgren, for years had imagined expanding their current horse breeding stables with the addition of a new white oak barn. As nature would have it, upon completing this new facility, the property took on a life of its own, and Stonewall Farms, weddings and events came to be. Since its conception, Stonewall Farms has been host to a wide variety of planned events, including business meetings, country music videos, political rallies, photo shoots, and of course, weddings. Weddings at Stonewall Farms gives couples the ability to create a truly unique and memorable experience. Located in central Minnesota, 1 hour and 15 minutes southwest of the Twin Cities, and just 5 miles north of the city of Wilmer, Stonewall Farms, 87 acres, are located on the banks of scenic Solomon Lake. Currently, only 14 acres of the property are actively used for events. The steady growth in popularity and event bookings has sparked a new idea in the minds of Stonewall Farms owners. An expansion of Stonewall Farms event facilities into this underutilized 56-acre portion of the property. As derived from in-depth discussion between Stonewall Farms owners and the designer, these are the program elements to be included in the new expansion. First is to create a sense of arrival through the design of a new entry gate. The second program element is to implement 300 new parking spaces on the site to accommodate the needs of the new expansion. Third, Stonewall Farms would like to employ elements into the landscape to create a unique sense of place. This will be accomplished through the design of a new bridge to access Shepherd's Island and other strategic site alterations to frame views and provoke the visitor's imagination. Finally, the pinnacle element of the new Stonewall Farms expansion is the design of an amphitheater with a capacity to seat 500 guests. This location has been chosen as the best place for the new entry to the Stonewall Farms expansion property. This decision was based on the location's proximity to the 25-foot-wide existing public gravel road from which all guests will enter the site. In this late March photograph, the existing topography and planting palette of the proposed entry site can be better understood. The existing topography of the site and the break in established vegetation make this the ideal location for the development of the new Stonewall Farms entry. Established row plantings of Scotch pine and black walnut trees exist on site, and groupings of hardwood shrubs, multi-leader maple, and dogwood species buffer the site from the road. The design of the new Stonewall Farms entry begins with a new 10-foot-wide gravel entry road. This new road design incorporates sections of grass center lines influenced by classical period carriage roads. Two dry stack boulder walls have been integrated to stabilize the new grading plan. The large stones these walls are to be constructed of come from boulder deposits located on the Stonewall Farms property. The design intention is to make an immediate visual connection between the Stonewall Farms name and the site. Two elements have been included to give Stonewall Farms event guests a sense of arrival to the Stonewall Farms expansion. The first is a masonry sign that clearly demonstrates to guests that they have arrived at Stonewall Farms. This masonry sign has been strategically placed within the property line, clearly visible to traffic. Based on site analysis, it is evident that all guests will make a westbound arrival to the site. Because of this, the entry sign's plantings have been composed to complement the sign from this vantage point. The sign's design reflects current themes found in the architecture and landscape of existing Stonewall Farms facilities and introduce guests to the expansion's material palette. The entry's planting plan has been developed to enhance the sense of arrival to the site while creating a sensitive connection to the existing plantings. The primary focal element of the design is a new entry gate. This gate design includes 2 6-foot-tall masonry pillars. Each one, filled with cement, would have appropriately scaled footings and would be used to support the gate's wrought iron works. The black stained concrete capped masonry pillars boast an ashlar pattern reflective of the entry sign. These custom wrought iron works are to be fabricated to the designer's specifications as illustrated. The design of these iron works is reiterated throughout the entirety of the Stonewall Farms expansion with the intent of creating a unique and memorable new sense of identity. Shrub roses ground the gate's appearance, and a diverse, asymmetrical planting backdrop frames the gate within the landscape. The designer has purposely located the entry gate 60 feet from the public gravel road. This distance allows vehicles a few moments for the narrow nature of the road and composed scenery to slow vehicles, as guests anticipate the passage through the 11-foot-wide gates and begin their Stonewall Farms experience. This experience begins with a time of decompression, as the 1/3-mile-long entry road winds through the naturalistic scenery, taking advantage of the existing topography to frame views within the landscape. This decompression phase ends, and a time of interpretation begins as the guests arrive at the designated parking zone. The new parking zone has been integrated into the site's topography, allowing for minimal regrading. This new grading plan was designed to direct as much stormwater runoff as possible into Shepherd's Island Bay. Shepherd's Island Bay is densely vegetated and home to a diverse array of aquatic plant species that would ensure the filtration of any pollutants brought on site through vehicle or traffic. The new parking lot's design breaks up the 300 parking spaces into easily programmable cells. This cell-like formation gives Stonewall Farms event staff the ability to easily designate cells for individual use. These 10-foot roads are currently used by Stonewall Farms. The new parking lot has been designed to serve as overflow parking for Stonewall Farms' existing facilities when needed. Stonewall Farms expansion guests enter the new parking lot from the east. The designer has specifically developed this entry's planting plan to create a sense of arrival and frame the signage that is critical at this stage to ensure proper orientation for guests on site. 3 separate circulation patterns were taken into consideration. These are guest vehicular, equestrian carriage, and a staff-operated shuttle for elderly and disabled guests. The parking lot's design incorporates 4-foot-wide gravel pedestrian paths. These paths include wayfinding signage to further orientate and improve safety on site by separating pedestrian and vehicular traffic. The irregular shape of the parking lot integrates with the existing established plantings. And the new planting plan screens views and helps break up the monotony of the 3-acre parking zone. From here, guests are immersed in a unique progression of space as they exit their vehicles and make their way to secluded Shepherd's Island. The man-made land bridge that connects Shepherd's Island to the rest of the Stonewall Farms property presents opportunities to enhancing the visitor's experience and interpretation of the site. This existing land bridge was created in the 60s to allow farmers to graze flocks of sheep on the 10-acre Shepherd's Island. In its creation, however, the natural circulation of Solomon Lake was permanently altered. And today, a drastic contrast in water quality is clearly evident on either side of the land bridge. A plan has been developed that creates a breach in the land bridge. This new plan begins with the pouring of large footings on either side of the breach, which will become the foundation for a new bridge. The center of the land bridge was the best choice to place this crossing, as Stonewall Farms' white oak barn can be viewed from this vantage point, and would create a visual connection between existing Stonewall Farms facilities and the new expansion. With the water circulation of Solomon Lake restored to its original state, the natural reclamation process of Shepherd's Island Bay can begin. Two large footings have been designed to carry the weight of the new bridge. A series of steel I-beams will make a connection between the foundation's footings, upon which a wooden support structure will be built. This wooden structure will support the reinforced concrete arch that makes up the bridge's primary structural unit as it cures. Next, the stone masonry will be applied, followed by additional reinforced concrete, at which point the wooden support structure can be removed. Dry stack boulder walls retain the ramp up to the bridge on either side, and white oak guardrails ensure a safe crossing. The colorful ashlar stone masonry is complemented by the staining of all concrete elements black. To enhance the unique character of this bridge, an embellishment has been designed that includes the year in which the construction would be completed. It was determined that the new bridge's design incorporates a secondary pedestrian bridge. Supported on the steel I-beams from pre-construction, this pedestrian bridge would encourage guest interaction with Solomon Lake. From atop the bridge, expansive views of the undeveloped shorelines would provide guests a breathtaking interpretation of Shepherd's Island's naturalistic setting. The bridge's final master plan was developed to leave a memorable impression in the minds of users. A soil saturation tolerant planting plan includes weeping willow, river birch, and poplars, as well as other colorful ornamental shrubs and perennial species. This protrusion from the linear plan provides a vantage point from which the bridge's form and details can be better appreciated. The unique experience of this crossing sets Stonewall Farms apart from all outdoor venues in the region, and is an experience that is shared by all event-goers on their way to the new Shepherd's Island Amphitheater. Examination of the expansion property's topography has revealed this section of Shepherd's Island to be the ideal place for the implementation of Stonewall Farms' new Shepherd's Island Amphitheater. This decision was based on the site's existing amphitheater-like topographical features. The existing slope of this portion of the site ranges from 8 to 12%, and terracing would be possible with limited regrading. Orientation of this site is also ideal, as it provides an expansive view corridor of Solomon Lake's undeveloped shorelines. This 8-foot-wide gravel road currently bisects the site. Existing plantings include bur oak, box elder, red cedar, and other naturally occurring native plant species. In preparations for site development, this 3/4-acre area has been cleared. The existing road has been widened to a more accommodating 10-foot width and has been rerouted. This new route allows visitors to experience a greater portion of the site's existing natural forest landscape, as well as improve site progression by limiting view corridors into the site. The site's grading plan has been modified in a way that both reacts to the existing topography and needs of the amphitheater. Swales have been created to maximize drainage of the amphitheater. A trellis has been utilized to create a sense of arrival and point of entry. Two structures have been included in the design. The first is an open floor plan gazebo. Elevated 3 feet above the simplistic focal point, this structure becomes the stage's primary stage right framing element. The intended use of this gazebo is to become a staging space for musicians or other event needs requiring shelter. The second smaller gazebo has been oriented with a direct line of sight to the larger gazebo. This structure is used to house technical personnel during an event. Organic 16-inch tall seat walls make up the amphitheater's terraced design. Stairs have been integrated intermittently to improve guest circulation. An ADA-compatible central aisle utilizes cheek walls to give the aisle a slight sense of elevation and minimize the slope of the ramp. A removable dock encourages interaction with Solomon Lake, and an adjoining patio effectively creates a backstage for the amphitheater. Removable chairs allow the amphitheater to reach the full 500 guest capacity. The amphitheater's planting plan has been composed in a way that both enhances the visual experience while improving the functionality of the amphitheater. Plant species have been selected that reflect the existing Stonewall Farms plant palette, along with a few new species to improve the site's own unique character within Stonewall Farms. Evergreen species have been used to create consistent color throughout the changing seasons and form windbreaks. Scotch pine trees have been picked as the primary transition species between new and existing plantings. Found prevalently on Stonewall Farms, this species was selected for its rich bark color and dense canopy that is created when planted in groups. Blue spruce, also a mainstay Stonewall Farms species, was selected for its blue-green color and effective use as a view screen. Canadian hemlock and Japanese cypress were used throughout the design. These evergreen species are used to improve framing composition and give depth to backdrops. A diverse color palette of deciduous plant species has been implemented to generate dynamic seasonal color change on site. Clusters of multi-liter river birch were used to diversify the overall planting texture. Columnar Swedish aspen provide a vertical element to the planting plan. White and red splendor flowering crab trees provide color and fragrance in the spring, and red berries add a burst of color during the late fall and winter months. Japanese maple trees frame views, and the rich browns and reds of Diablo 9 bark and sumac have been integrated into backdrops. Ornamental planting beds include purple salvia, light pink shrub roses, and tall ornamental grasses. A variety of maple species have been chosen to produce areas of dense shade and are utilized for their dynamic fall colors. Finally, thornless honey locust was chosen to counteract the harsh southwestern setting sun by being integrated into the amphitheater's terraces. These trees would provide dappled shade over the majority of the amphitheater seating space, while allowing enough sunlight to penetrate to maintain healthy turf. As the event draws to a close and guests make their way to their vehicles, the excitement of the day begins to dim. The designer's intention is that the experience these guests have encountered at the Stonewall Farms expansion leaves them with a new perspective of what an outdoor Midwest event venue can be, eager for the next opportunity to return.